We need plastic in every aspect of our life, for eating, to write with pens, to brush, to travel, and almost all activities we do on the daily basis. So, where do these all plastic goes? Some of these are exported and some of these goes for recycling. But most of this plastic ends up in the ocean, which pollutes the environment and causes the death of thousands of living organisms. Plastic is made up of the polymer, so it cannot be broken down due to the microorganisms. It is non-biodegradable. The ratio of the plastic and marine animals in the ocean is 6:1. This plastic is very dangerous for all the living things. Over 270 species have currently been affected by this plastic, and over 1 million birds and 1 lakh marine mammals have been died. Even though we banned plastic bags, if people followed it too, yet huge amount of plastic will go in dumps or landfills, and more than that, in the oceans, risking more than 700 species in danger. What we have done is, we are using those waste plastic in our project, that is Paver Block, in which we have replaced conventional material total with waste material. Now, our next material is furnace foundry sand. Furnace foundry sands are the wastes generated by foundries. It is a relevant source to be reused in construction primarily. Hence, we are replacing foundry sand by fine aggregates. This will fill the voids. And our next material is crushed tiles. It is an industrial waste that causes environmental pollution. The utilization of crushed tile as a coarse aggregate in paver blocks would have positive effect on economy.
So the waste materials which we are going to use are waste plastic, waste crushed tile particles, and foundry furnace sand, which is also called as a mold sand. As shown in the previous video, these are the waste materials which we have used: waste plastic, foundry sand, waste furnace foundry sand, and crushed tile particles. Initially, first we have melted this plastic and mixed with it with foundry sand and tile particles in proportion of 1:1.5:2. Then we have placed this mixture in this mold and formed the paving block. The dimension of the paving block is 20 cm by 10 cm by 5 cm. Though there are many reports available on this topic, what they have did in that report is that they have replaced some amount of waste materials with the conventional material. But the novelty of our topic is that we are going to use 100% of the waste materials in our paving block, and without disturbing any properties and maintaining the quality of the paving block.
Here is the difference between conventional material and waste materials that are used in paving blocks. Cement is used as binding agent, whereas plastic is used as binding agent in our paving blocks. Sand used to fill intermediate voids or gaps between aggregates in conventional method, and foundry sand, that is mold sand, used to fill intermediate voids or gaps between aggregates in our paving block. Here, aggregates provide strength in conventional material, whereas waste crushed tile particles provide strength in our paving block. Water is required in conventional method, and no water is required in our paving blocks. Here we can see the compressive strength between conventional method and our method is same, that is M15 to M35, that is 20 newton per mm square. Here is the difference between cost used in conventional method, that is 12 to 16 rupees, and the cost for our paving material is